Hey guys, in this video I'm gonna show you how to compile a dedicated server for Linux using Windows PC. So first of all, you need to download something called Unreal Toolchain. You can find the link down below. So make sure to choose the correct version based on your Unreal Engine version. So I have Unreal Engine 4.24, so I have downloaded this one. After that, you need to double click on it. And proceed with the installation. You can change the destination, but make sure to copy the destination where you want to install the Unreal Engine toolchain. I have already installed it, so I'm gonna cancel this installation process. After that, we need to add a variable to environment, Windows environment variables. So press the Windows button, type environment variables, select the second option, and now press environment variables. We need to add a new environment variable. It should be called Linux multi-arc root. And then here on the variable value, we need to paste the destination where we have installed the Unreal Engine toolchain. After that, you need to press OK, OK, OK. And now we are almost ready to start the compilation process. Okay, so you need to go to your game project. You need to regenerate the Visual Studio solution using this one, generate Visual Studio project files. And wait for a moment. After finish generating the Visual Studio solution, you will find a new file. Its name starts with your game project name and ends with .sln. Double click on it. I'm using the Visual Studio 2017, but you might use any Visual Studio version compatible with Unreal Engine. Wait for it to load. Okay, so now we need to recompile a few things here. I have assumed that you have already downloaded the Unreal Engine source code and compiled it. So go to Programs. We need to recompile or rebuild automation tool. Just right click on it and press Rebuild. Wait for it to finish. After that, we need to recompile Unreal Build tool, rebuild it. Then we need to rebuild the Unreal front end. Okay, so now we have finished the compile of everything. This step will be done only once when you have installed the Unreal toolchain. So now we need to go to the solution configuration and choose development server. After that, go to solution platform and choose Linux. If this option is not available, just go to the project files and right click on the Unreal Engine project, generate Visual Studio project files again. Okay. So now I'm gonna go here and build the solution. It's not gonna take too much here on my computer because I have already built it. I'm gonna pause the video and come back when everything is finished. So now we have finished the compile of the project. You should get a log similar to mine, built successfully. And after that, you can find a new file located on the binaries Linux. You will find four files. Its name started with your game project name and ends with server. Okay. So now you can close the Visual Studio. You need to go to Unreal Engine front end. It's gonna take some time to load. Now everything is loaded. So let's create a new launch profile. I've already created a new one. Go to it and select your Unreal Engine project file. Just go where you have placed it and select this one. Here you need to select development if your game is still under development, or shipping if it's ready for shipping. Then choose select build UAT. Here you need to select book by the book. we need to select the platforms that we need to compile for. So here we are gonna compile for two platforms. The first one is Windows, and it's going to be used by the clients or the players. And the other one is the Linux that's going to handle the server of the game. So make sure to check Linux server and Windows No Editor. If Linux server is not available, if this option is not available, just go back to Visual Studio file and recompile the front end, Unreal Engine front end. You need to check the language and select all the maps that should be cooked. Next, you need to select package and store locally and browse where you want to save everything. Sorry, and check do not deploy. Okay, so now we are ready to start the build. Press this one, launch this profile, and wait forever for it to finish. It's gonna take a long time, especially if your hardware is not that much powerful. I'm gonna pause the video and come back whenever it's finished. Now, if everything went correctly, you are going to note that there is a green arrow in front of every line here. There should not be any error. Now you can press done. Now it's the time to upload the server to the VPS. So first of all, we need to remember where we have saved everything. Just go to edit profile and you can find the destination here. Okay, now I'm gonna close the Unreal Engine front end and go to the destination. You are going to see Linux server, enter it, and package everything. Make sure to choose zip because it's easier to extract on the Linux server, and best to shrink the size. Press OK and wait for it to finish. We have finished compressing the server files. We need to upload them to any drive. I'm using Google Drive personally. You can use anyone other than that. And you need to download it on your Linux VPS and extract it to a folder. And remember where you have extracted it. So I'm not gonna go through this process because it's pretty straightforward. After that, we need to access our VPS using a PuTTY SSH connection. We need to know where we are running now using the command ls. I've placed it inside the folder that's called DSS. There is a new folder called binaries. The server files is extracted there. So let's go to where the files located by typing change directory dot slash dss slash binaries. Okay, now we can see that we have all the project files or all the server files. We need to make the mmo server.sh executable. So we need to type chmod space plus x and then dot space mmo server.sh. Now, if you type ls, you are going to notice that its color became green, which means it's now executable. Just type dot slash mmo server.sh and your server should be launched. Okay, everything is working fine. The server launched correctly. So if you have any question, just leave it on the comments down below. I'm gonna try to answer all of your questions. Thank you for watching. See you in another video.